everybody, it's Heather here at the Craft Shack, and I have a special treat for you today because I am going to finish up the piece from Tuesday that we did with Cece. So that was a fabulous time, a really great adventure actually, and I can't wait to see what comes of more of those. But anyway, this is the piece where I left it, and I sprayed it with some SpectraFix because it did have that magicals that I ended with, that olive-colored magicals there in the middle of what was going to be a tree, and I couldn't quite make it work. I know what you guys saw, but I couldn't see it. It was driving me nuts, and I slept on this. I really did. I slept on it like, what is gonna be on this thing? I got to do something with it, and I woke up this morning thinking about a particular embrace. Like, what I really wanted was a man holding his girl's face and he's about to kiss her, and like I wanted the hand around her jowl area, but I couldn't find a picture that made me happy, that did that encaptured, captured what I was trying to portray here. And I did like I always do. I went to Pinterest to try and find some inspiration, and I do end up putting the inspiration picture at the end of this video so you can see where the lines are coming from as I'm drawing them. But excuse me, the idea was, as I started, and I don't know if you want to hear this kind of stuff or not, but whenever I'm drawing something, I never know quite where to start. And so what I found to be the easiest after all this time of doing this is to find a negative space. So I started with the lines where they're kind of where their noses meet, more like up where her eyebrows and his nose meet, and created that negative line, the line that is actually the background that creates the line of his nose and the line of the bridge of her nose and her brow line there. And that's where I started. Then it was easy to kind of make the lines come down further. And whenever I'm drawing, I always look for shapes like ovals, triangles, squares, and everything. Everything is a shape. So her lip there was a elongated triangle. And then you can fix the edges that are not necessarily a triangle. It's more of a rounded lip that puckers in like that. Now, placement is funny because I know that her eyebrow's up there by that ridge, so why is her eye way down here? Yeah, we'll fix that. And that's just a baby wipe. And so I'm using a Stabilo All pencil to bring in some of these lines. And the reason why I chose that is for two reasons. One, it marks on the acrylic paint that we've already laid down, so I know that I can get my marks on there really well. And then the second thing is because it will activate with water, and so I can take my rough pencil drawing and turn it into an actual painting using the Stabilo. Now, the Stabilo is not, it's not a finished piece of charcoal, so it's probably not going to stay. If somebody were to splash water on this piece of art, then it is going to ruin everything. But I guess the way I'm looking at it is, if you are so careless as to spray water on your art, maybe you shouldn't have any. I've actually I used to sell artwork in different ways, and one of my customers had actually done that. I bought the piece back from her, and I used it in another piece of art. So it wasn't my own piece of art. It was something that was, manufactured, and she got it wet and it ruined the picture. What do you know? Anyway, okay, so let's move on. So I got the basic idea or the outline of what I wanted to do, and now I've got just a large, this is my favorite water brush, round brush, that I just love watercoloring with this. And I started off with just a tiny bit of water because I didn't really want it to get too liquidy and spread everywhere, but that obviously was not good enough. And then when I move the brush over to the right, I'm just dabbing off a little bit of water because it's clearly too much. And And at some point it kind of goes a little wrong here, but that's okay. I just use clean water and kind of shape that up again. And there I closed the gap of where his mouth was a little bit more open. And eventually I'm going to fix that because that just drives me nuts. That just doesn't look right. And there, too much water. See what I did? Too much water. But don't worry about it because this is all just really the rough. And it's easy to fix with a baby wipe here and there or some clean water to come in and clean it up. And I do go in and kind of fine line a little bit more with, I use the same brush for almost all of this, so that part doesn't bother me. But I do kind of go in with a little bit of more pencil stroke and not activate it, so that way it is more defined. I'm looking over here at the finished piece, but you're going to see pictures at the end of everything. I really just wanted to let you watch me paint this instead of talking to you about it, but I know that there are questions that are going to be asked. So, as I was doing this, I wanted to give her some hair, and I put too much water on the brush. And in the reference photo, she has these wisps of hair that came down, and I needed that to be in the picture. I'm so glad that I put those there too, because it just sort of added to it. And the parts that I don't like, the best thing to do here is to not touch it when it's totally wet and everything. Just leave it alone. So there I go in. The canvas was wet, so the pencil is a little bit more activated as I put it down, which is good. And then I move on to another section. So if I don't like something, I'm not going to keep fiddling with it. I'm going to wait until it's dryable, dryable, until it's dry enough to mess with it. So there gives you a bigger view of the big picture is what I'm trying to say here. So now I liked how they sort of disappeared. Like you see there, the moment where they come together, that's pretty detailed and defined, but everything beyond their cheeks really is gone. It's just sort of faded off into the photo or into the image. And that's really what I wanted the whole thing to be. Is just really more faded out. And as I was, painting these lines and everything, I realized that he kind of disappears a lot more than I thought he would, but there's nothing really blocking him. So it's like, why is he disappearing? So I am going to add a little bit more of the quinacridone, nickel, azo gold, and gesso through that harlequin stencil. And that just brings me to the 3-2-1 challenge. This is the whole purpose of this canvas was, first of all, I got to hang out with Cece, y'all. That is just so cool to get to, for Sylvia and I to be able to be in a hangout with her and bring her live artwork to the folks that watch the show. That was just amazing. And I know a lot of her fans came over and watch the show, which was great. It was so good to have so many people there to enjoy a live presentation from such a great artist. And I was dumbfounded. I really was as I watched her piece come together. I got kind of caught up in that moment and really forgot that I was supposed to be doing something too. And so my piece just took a total different turn. And if you watch that episode, you'll see what happened. But the idea was to do a 3-2-1 challenge. So we had three colors, and Cece chose all this. So we had three colors, which was the quinacridone, nickel, azo gold, which I just turned into like a yellow gold. You just want something in the golden yellow family, okay? And then the PBO Studio Dyna blue green. Or green blue, it's the green blue, number 358. That was the second color, and then the third color was a green olive, and she used magicals for that. And I tried to as well, which is that center part of the thing they're trying to make that tree trunk. It just did not work out. But anyway, those are the three colors, and then you have two stencils. And I chose a sunflower stencil that I only used the center of, and they When I was doing the show, there were comments that it looked a lot like fireworks, which is where this image came to my head, that I wanted it to be like that moment. You know, everybody talks about having those sparks fly when the kiss happens. And so I wanted to capture that on this, and then it's like the fireworks are going off around them, and they're kind of stolen away to this moment. And so I had to put words on it, of course. So I'm just using my tiny little stamps that I love this set of stamps because I think it cost me 50 cents in the clearance bin at Walmart. Anyway, so I'm just doing some Versamark ink, so sparks fly, and then some Wow embossing powder in rich gold, which we do sell in the store, of course, and put that onto just a scratch piece of paper, and we'll glue it on. And then I do go back in after I put the words on. I will go back in and add some details to bring some of those harlequin shapes forward. And I realized that their faces were a little bit flat, so I needed to add some highlights, and I kind of struggle with that. So you'll get to see some of that. And then after I was done and I was taking pictures for the video, I realized that there were a couple of details that I had kind of missed. So the very last picture that you see here at the end of this video will have the completion. You'll notice that there's just a wisp of her other eyelash coming out from the other side of her nose, and I think I've corrected her nose so she doesn't have a witchy or bleeding nose either. But and her lips too. I had to fix her lips, which I didn't notice any of that until I was taking the pictures. And that just leads me to, you really do need to take a different perspective to your artwork. So what you're doing with it when you're looking at it in one way, walk away or take a picture or do something so that you get a different perspective of it. Study that for a few minutes and see, you might find out what's wrong with it instantly. That's been my experience anyway. So like I said, just adding some details to some of the harlequins shapes, those diamond shapes, just to push them or bring them forward so that they're more floating in front of the kiss per se, and then everything else seems to be far away in the background. At least that was my intention. I don't know if it comes across or not, but that was my intention. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it. I really had a great time. I hope that you will follow along in the challenge this month for the month of November and tag your project submissions wherever you post them in any social media outlet with the hashtag KSC for Craft Shack Challenge and NOV for November and 15 for the year. So it's KSCNOV15. That's the hashtag to use. So that way I can find it, and then you'll be entered to win the prize package this month, which I haven't posted yet. So hopefully by the time you see this video, there will be a link for you to go find the challenge information and know exactly what's up for grabs. So this is where you see me struggling with making a few mistakes as far as trying to get some highlights in there. I used the wrong pen. Don't use the Posca pen for this. Normally it works pretty well, but right about there I realized, or no, it was here, is the nose. I realized this is not the pen to use. All of a sudden she has like a witch's nose. So I'm going to fix it, but I'm going to fix it by making it ugly first. So here we go. Add some water while it's wet. Add some water. That'll help dilute the problem. And I'm kind of spreading it out. I know, don't freak out, okay? We can handle this. We're good. And then I dabbed it off with the baby wipe, so that way it's almost gone. It's just a whisper of a line now, which is perfect. Now I can go in with the Stabilo All Pencil in white and add the highlights properly. And that will do it. Yep, Stabilo in white. And I really wanted his face to appear that it was tilted towards her, it's more more tilted towards hers than it was coming straight on her. And I think those highlights really helped with that. See, pick it up and look at it. Change the perspective. And then I struggle with where to put my name, but you know what? I figured it out. I put my name down. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Put a big thumbs up and please visit Crafters Community. Have a great day. Bye, guys, everybody. Have a great day.